Peace, guys, and welcome to a new video. Today, we're watching another fan edit. We are watching Brooke Davis Paralyzed by Alexis. It has 15,666 views. And yeah, it's a One Tree Hill edit. I absolutely adore Brooke. She is my favorite character in One Tree Hill. Like, Nathan is a close second, and then Haley is also up there. But, like, Brooke is actually my favorite character in One Tree Hill. So, I love her so much, and she has such a great character development from, like, the first season till the end. It is amazing. And she has such a great character development and such a great story arc. So, yeah. She's awesome. Okay, lean back, kick up your feet, and let's go, guys. If you like this video, please leave a like, or maybe even comment something, because like, comment, and sharing this video, or any of those, help the algorithm to figure out that people actually like this video, and show it to other people that might also like this video. So it would really help me to be seen in like the endless depths of YouTube. So leave a like, or a comment, and yeah, let's get straight into it. Let's go. Paralyzed.
Rather feel nothing.
This song is really sad.
It's better, it's easier.
Yeah, it's easier, but is it really better though? Because if you feel nothing, you also like don't feel the good things. You just feel nothing. And like if you don't feel anything, you don't feel the good things, and if you don't feel the good things, you don't live for the good things, and if you don't live for the good things, what are you living for? Like, that easily goes into, like, depression and trying to kill yourself. When did I lose myself? I love this song, but it's also so sad. Yeah, Brooke went through some shit. Like... Peyton also went through some serious shit, like a lot, like Peyton was basically the punching bag for the writers in One Tree Hill, but like Brooke also wasn't like unscarred, like her mother is a bitch, like a total bitch. She just gets a little bit better later on, but like first off, she's a total bitch. We don't know anything about, not much about her father. Then the first boy she ever like opened herself up, betrayed her with her best friend. And then get basically all the guys she's been with are terrible. Like it always ended badly. It always did. And then she gets poor, and this happens to her on the screen later on after she has her own business, and her mother takes her business away because her business is more important to her than her daughter. And like so much happens to her. Later on, she nearly dies while saving Jamie. But at least later on, she finds Julian. And her best friend and Lucas get back together again. After she gave him a second chance. And yeah, they get back together again. Actually, they kiss again while he's together with Brooke. So, yeah. Also, there's the whole school shooting thing, even though she's like out there, but it's like also very bad for her because all of her friends are inside. And she's the only one that got out, so, yeah. And she has such a great character development. She grows so much over the seasons, and she has such a big heart. And I mean, her and Sam, oh my god, she is so motherly, I love her. And she's also like humorly and funny and everything. Like, she is so many like contradicting things. Yeah, I think she had like really, really bad face back when that happens. When she get like attacked in her own shop, and she like tells no one, and then Nathan comes later on and is like, are you okay? And she's like, yeah, And he's like, that sounds like something I would say. Like, he knows that something is wrong. And she has, like, this moment where she's, like, kind of... I think she's depressed at that time. Because, like, she sees only the bad in the world anymore. Yeah, that's in the school shooting. When she's outside and all her people are inside. All her friends are inside. Oh, I love this scene so much. I love this scene. Like, I think I actually can, like, tell it, say the lines by heart. Like, I think I actually, I need you to need me back. And why haven't you been calling when I was away? And why won't you ever let me all the way in? I'm holding on for dear... I forgot the line. That I'm holding on for dear life, Lucas, but I need you to need me back. Yeah. I can literally, basically... Like, I can basically tell that speech. So. By heart. I know that speech by heart by now. When did I become so... Oh, yeah, when she was, like... celebrating her birthday alone. I loved that episode where, like, they all had to, like, kind of push through the stereotypes and through the things they, like, thought of people and, like, get to know people that they don't know so well better, and then make a photo at the end of who they think that person is that, like, shows them the most, because, like, they were all stuck in, like, that high school stereotypes, and I mean, even in real life outside of high school, we're all stuck in those stereotypes still. It's not as immensely extreme as in, like, high school, I think, but it's still very prominent. But yeah, and so they like, all like, had to get to know the other people they did not know better. To, like, push through those stereotypes and really get to know them beyond the stereotype they had of them. Oh yeah, when she has to give, like, the little girl up on the station because she has to go back to her parents. Angie was her name, I think, right? Something like that. Poor Brooke. And then there's, like, Lucas right there, because you know exactly that, like, Brooke is not going to be able to drive herself home right now, and, like, it's heartbreaking for her. Like, it's so it's really, really hard for her, so he know that she needed a friend. That was awesome. I must have left with all my faith. Yeah, she does not even tell Peyton. She just tells no one because she does not, like, want to get in the way of their happiness. That she actually got attacked. And Peyton just later on finds out. Oh yeah, this is also so awesome when she's, like, looking for Sam. Like, she went to this guy, the brother of Sam's friend, and Sam ran away, and Sam is missing, and she's looking for her, and she went to that guy, the brother of that friend, and he says Sam is not there, and then he goes out, and then he says the same thing that he said when he attacked her in a stop, even though she could not see him then. And that's the moment when she knows that he's the guy that attacked her in a stone. That's the moment when she knows that Sam has to be in there somewhere. And she just goes in, kicks in the door, faces that dude that she was so afraid of, that, like, hurt her so badly. Like, just faces him right off, like, kicks the door and makes pepper spray in his face and goes through the whole house screaming for Sam, trying to get her, and, like, she's just, like, 100% mother instinct mode, you know? It's just beautiful. And she's not waiting for the police and no one. She's not letting Sam in there, like, one more second, and just, like, even when Sam says she should leave, she's like, no, I'm not leaving you here. Never. And then she, like, gets attacked by that dude again, and she pulls the gun on him, and she tries, and she really wants to shoot him because she hates him so much, and she's so afraid. And then Sam says, please don't leave me, Mom, or I need you, Mom, or something like that, because if she shoots him in that position, she will go to prison, you know? And that's when, like, you can really see everything in Brooke's face change. Like, she's like, I am not gonna, like, sacrifice my life, basically, for you. I'm not gonna spend one more second with you. Like, Sam needs me. Oh my god, that was so awesome. I was actually crying. I'm close to tears right now, but not because it's sad, but because it's so fucking beautiful. Yeah, that scene. Then she just kicks him in the face with the gun. And you can see, like, how she is fighting with every fiber of her body, even after Sam says that, to, like, not pull the trigger. Ah, she and Julian. Oh yeah, and then she figures out that she's not even able to get kids, even though she, like, she wants to be a mother so badly, and everything about her, she's just that person who she just needs to be a mother. She's just made for it, you know? And then she figures out that she, like, can't have kids. And I'm like, yeah, keep punching, guys. Keep punching her, sure. Because it was, like, so heartbreaking. Oh. Oh yeah, that I hated Peyton back then. I'm in general not the biggest fan of Peyton, but like normally I don't hate her. But like I hated Peyton in this situation because like Lucas broke up with Brooke, and she was like there crying, and Peyton was not there for her whatsoever. Like Peyton was not there for Brooke in general ever when she needed her. Like Brooke was always there for Peyton when Peyton needed her, but Peyton was never there, basically never there for Brooke when Brooke needed her. Like, even at the airplane when she gave up Angie, like, even when they get close again and she gave up Angie, even at the airport, it's Lucas who's there for her. Not Peyton, her best friend. No, it's Lucas. I don't know what Peyton is doing at the time, but I don't really care. And she has such a big heart, oh my god, yeah. So, I won't reveal all the people are going through so much all the time, but like, and Peyton definitely like, is the punching bag for the writers the whole time, but Brooke also goes through some shit, and those shit is like, it's just making her a better person. Like, it's not like she could go through all that shit and she could become bitter and worse and everything, but like, she's not closing off her heart, or she's kind of closing off her heart to other guys, but not totally. But like, she's not closing herself off because of that, and she's not becoming bitter, she's not becoming like less emotional, less caring for people. She's just become better and better. She gets so much stronger, her character development gets so much stronger. She's still so like caring about people and everything. It's just, she's just awesome. I love it. Okay. What do you think about Brooke Davis, or One Tree Hill in general, but also what do you think about Brooke Davis? Write in the comments, who is your favorite character in One Tree Hill? Also write that in the comments. And yeah, then I will hope I will see you in my next video again. Until then, bye guys!